Okay, leaving clean water behind, let's move across into Section C, sanitary plumbing and drainage. Now we jump across to the dark side and I'll give you some insight into the changes in Section C, sanitary plumbing and drainage. I'm proud to say that the ABCB is leading the world in its work on sanitary plumbing and drainage pipe sizing, and a new pipe sizing method has been included as a verification method in NCC 2022. Aspects of the verification method includes determination of sanitary plumbing wastewater flow rates, a system 1 common discharge, a system 2 common discharge design, system 3 branch design, and the C1V5 is for stack design. These verification methods provide an alternative method to the use of fixture units outlined in ASNZS 3500.2. NCC 2022 and 2025 will bring a range of tools to improve the efficiency of sanitary plumbing systems. This is a snip from the PCA draft showing the new verification method for 2022 for determining wastewater flow rates. It is part of the ongoing work the ABCB office is doing in a building and performance option for new and innovative plumbing and drainage systems. At this point in time, whilst the new pipe sizing method won't alter the pipe sizes that are deemed to satisfy requirements of ASNZS 3500 to provide to any great extent, it will provide the ABC with platform to provide an accurate and modern pipe sizing method assisted by the additional research that will be conducted leading up to 2025. I'd like to say I'd let you spend a few moments identifying the equation there, but I'll just move on to slide 16. There are also new DTS provisions in Part C1 for 2022. As with cold water, we have carried over certain aspects into the sanitary plumbing side. These include bushfire prone areas and elements of water efficiency. This introduces further consistency across the PCA. Some people ask, why is it necessary for water efficiency provisions to be included when it comes to sanitary plumbing? But by including DTS provisions like this, a consistent national approach can be achieved. Following Part C1 comes Part C2, sanitary drainage systems. Sanitary drainage is all about getting rid of or disposing of the wastewater. Sanitary fixtures and sanitary appliances must be provided with an adequate disposal system that does not impact adversely on occupants of the premises, property, the environment, or the network utility operator's infrastructure. In 2019, there was really only one all-encompassing provision. So in 2022, the provisions have been pulled out separately. The new performance requirements include disposal, swimming pool drainage, access, ventilation, contamination, uncontrolled discharge, and damage. Add to the performance requirements we just saw, changes in this part includes a new pipe sizing method for sanitary drainage systems through the introduction of new verification methods. The two existing verification methods brought over from 2019 are velocity and liquid to air ratio and pressure testing. And the new verification method for 2022 is shown on this slide, determination of sanitary drainage wastewater flow rates. Extensive research has been carried out over the past few years to get to where we are today and has included some very highly qualified consultants, academia and manufacturers from around the world. Rigs like this one shown in a Sydney manufacturing plant has provided guidance on how advances in product design affects sanitary pipe sizing. The information we have received has informed the changes to the NCC 2022 and will continue to provide the basis where we are heading for 2025. Following this, the next step is including work on water pipe sizing, and this will include both cold water and heated water pipe sizing due to the different performance characteristics. On the homeward stretch now, so introducing Part C3, on-site wastewater management systems. This is new for 2022. Some of you may remember that on-site wastewater management systems was in NCC 2016, but not in 2019. Well, this edition sees its return, as it has been included in the NCC Volume 3 for 2022. This is another area where we have been working toward national consistency. The ABCB has been working with the regulators of on-site wastewater management systems across the country to develop nationally consistent requirements. This has included plumbing, health and environmental and protection agencies across the country. This part covers systems that facilitates the on-site storage, treatment, disposal and or reuse of wastewater, as well as any associated land application systems. Requirements for septic tanks, composting toilets, secondary treatment units, grey water systems and common effluent drainage systems are all outlined in this part. This is another area of work that may not be the responsibility of the plumbing regulator in your region, but again, most of the work is done by a licensed plumber. This is a new DTS for 2022. You'll see by the numbering that they are deemed to satisfy provisions that reference specific Australian standards. If a state and territory regulator variation exists, the viewer will see the links to the relevant regulatory body and any other specific requirements. And lastly, a little more on the interaction we have with Standards Australia. Standards play an important part in the PCA, and as you have seen, many of the DTS provisions refer to specific standards to attain compliance. NCC Volume 3 references over 40 standards, and these are included in Schedule 2. In all, the NCC series references around 200 Australian and international standards. The NCC Standards Management Team are an integral members of the development process for Standards Australia, and the ABC office is involved heavily. We can assure the user of the PCA that the reference standards are fit for purpose. This concludes this part of the NCC 2022 video series. I hope you have found the content interesting. Any comments or questions can be directed to us through the contact pages on the ABC website. Thank you for viewing.